Now, Your Excellency, first as SG of ODM, I want to confirm that we did receive communication from the Azimio Council directing that we write to each individual member of parliament in our respective parties. I want to confirm that I have dispatched 86 letters to the 86 members of the National Assembly elected on ODM, and I'm sure my counterparts in the other affiliate parties are doing the same, communicating the directive from the Council of Azimio that in fact all members of the National Assembly are to suspend any planned trips or any activities that would see them out of Nairobi for the duration of the consideration of the Finance Bill 2024, and that means from the date of tabling on Tuesday next week until a vote is taken. Now, last year, Your Excellency, you do remember that the coalition gave a position similar to the one that has given, that has been given this year again. Your Excellency, you will remember that we in ODM did undertake disciplinary proceedings against members of the party who either absconded or voted against the position of the coalition. But one of the problems that we are hoping to cure with the NADCO bills, Your Excellency, is that immediately political parties initiate disciplinary proceedings against their members, they run to court and obtain court orders that then tie the hands of the political parties in terms of what they can do. So the biggest solution, in fact, Kenyans don't realize how powerful they are. We are getting feedback from members of the National Assembly from ODM that they can hear Kenyans. Kenyans are able to reach those members of the National Assembly. And this is the biggest tool that you have as a Kenyan, somebody who has a vote. The regime does not fear Sifuna or any of us here. The regime fears the Mwananchi, calling them directly to tell them that chuma chako ki motoni, the way that my brother Eugene has said. The ultimate power is with the Mwananchi. If you repeatedly violate the interest of the Mwananchi, you must answer to the Mwananchi. And lastly, Your Excellency, you know, one of the economic advisors has invited us that he doesn't think that digital activism leads to anything, despite the fact that when the regime was harassing him last time, digital activism secured the release of David Ndii from police custody. Now he has invited us to be a little bit more touchy, if I may, hands-on. Yes, he has invited us to be a bit hands-on, because he says politics is a contact sport. We have already established that he worships at Our Lady of the Rosary in Roslyn. So we'll be joining him for Sunday Mass there, so that we are able to have contact with him and explain to him that we are unhappy with some of the policies that he's promoting in this government. Thank you.
Well done. I think he has actually answered. He's answered that bit. This digital activism is proving very effective. We will review our position as we go along.
It's clear that what we are saying as Azimio is that we condemn the budget and the finance bill in total, and we actually reject it from this platform, or reject them from where we stand, and are asking our members of parliament to hear it. Hear the members of the public. Listen to what we are telling you. You are elected to represent the people, not to represent the disaster in the name of Ruto. And why do I call him a disaster? He has reduced school feeding program by 2 billion shillings. He has reduced the education budget by 25%. Special education by 35%. The primary education by 20%. We can actually see the return of provincial administration in full swing, to the point where the chiefs are now required to ensure that you have complied with your tax requirements. Back to the dark old days. I think it is important to also note that the special protection, Pesa Wazee, has been reduced by 3 billion shillings. We have 16 days to the end of the financial year or something like that, and you should be on the lookout for the mother of all times in terms of corruption. The stealing that will happen between now and the end of the financial year, it's something that if it was addressed the last financial time when you were budgeting and leading the finance bill, the burden that we have already gone through will not have been occasioned on Kenyans. Why? Because there are very many of the votes that have not been exhausted, and they will be doing everything else, including buying of shoes and belts, to ensure that they exhaust that money. His Excellency has mentioned about our former president. And I think what he was saying, in short, what I heard, is that in the last financial year, his office had been allocated something like 600 million shillings. Throughout that period, he had only received 28 million shillings. The barons had also been spent. And alikuwa nauliza, nani alikula? Wakenya waabiwe, na wache kuabiwa kwamba alipatiwa. And why you need a committee to answer such a simple question, it actually helps you to know that Mwizi must be part of that committee or one constituting the committee. And I want to say this, nimalize na kusema, ya kwamba this double speak, wale ambao wako na magari msome vizuri. Dungu jana amesema, if you look at what he led and presented, there is no capping on the motor vehicle tax. In his presentation, there is no capping. Ni ingine tulikuwa tunasukuchwa hapa wa Kenya is what was given a cap of 100,000. So you start working on the cost of your vehicle or the value of your vehicle and know the corresponding amount of money that you need to pay on an annual basis. I think it is not useful anymore, perhaps to own a car. But I conclude by saying this. Look at the way they abandoned all the improvement on the transport sector, public transport sector. If that had been achieved, many people would choose to use the public transport and avoid buying cars. So you abandon one way and you kill us through the other way. We have a disaster budget, a disaster finance bill, and a disaster regime. Wa Kenya, let us send these guys home. Let them be a one-term regime. Na wale ambao wanafikiria ya kwamba utakaa kwa hiyo chimo ya ukora, na waze kusanya watu ati wakufuate ukiwa kwa hiyo chimo ya ukora, kwenda ukadaganya watu huko kwa village ama pahali ingine. We are not going to be fooled again. And again, I want to repeat this. Don't think that when you apologize and say all the other things you are saying, we are going to follow you. Kwa hiyo chimu ya wizi. We are not going to be part of that. This is the alternative, and you are working on it. Well, I thank you.
Thank you. Hi, Dorito.
Thank you. I think I'll only emphasize 3 points. The first is this question of budgeted corruption and the way in which it morphs. First, it is in the nature explained by the Honorable Kioni and the spokesperson for the fourth president, that you put figures in a vote, inflate them, or you don't disburse to the rightful person. I think you saw this previously, the controller of budget on record explaining to Kenyans that when you look at the amount put in the vote head used to pay her, you will see an amount that is several times what her annual salary is. Mm-hmm. The question is, have you another person who is also controller of budget? And that's what you're seeing. You put a figure in the benefits package of the retired president, then you don't disburse and you wonder who then is there. The other way budgeted corruption is, of course, you make provisions that outrightly, if you examine them, you could see something is amiss. As His Excellency explained to you, the National Treasury has a very interesting development vote called strategic responses to public initiatives. What is that vote? Or is it a slash fund for senior executives in the regime to use for? What is that vote? The second point I want to emphasize is that you cannot grow the economy by increasing taxes. I mean, honestly, ladies and gentlemen, fellow Kenyans, this regime is fond of traveling. They have been to the US today, I understand. They've gone to Italy and so on. They are fond of traveling. Throughout the world, governments are reducing taxes in order to stimulate economic activity. What is this voodoo-type economics where we think we are going to stimulate economic activity by increasing taxes? Finally, on the question of public debt, 70% of interest payments paid this year, and this year interest payments are going to be above 1.8 trillion. 70% of that is for domestic borrowing. The level of interest rate that we are paying for that debt is determined by the government. And by making that determination, it makes it harder for the private sector to operate. Again, I ask, what is this voodoo-type economics that makes them believe that private sector can afford to pay 30% for credit? Where, really, is that possible? Finally, to wade perhaps in an unfamiliar territory, some of people there in this regime advising them that, you know, politics is a contact sport. Well, perhaps I should urge Kenyans, well, let us take it up.
Correct.
Na tuwasalimie, mukiwaona mahali popote, muwasalimie in the manner that they want you to salimia them. I thank you.
Yeah, mutaende kanisa na
wawe. Asante. Nafikiri watu wote wameongea kizungu, nijaribu kiswahili kidogo. Na kwanza kushukuru wale wabunge, dhamana nane, ambao walipinga mswada wa mwaka jana, Finance Bill 2023. Kuna wale 176 walisema yes, na ndio sababu kila kitu kilipanda kutoka bottom kwenda juu, sababu ya ushuru. Masuala haya tuliyazungumzia kule kwenye maandamano, kwenye mahakama, na tukayazungumzia kule kwenye Bomas. Lakini Kenya Kwanza walikataa katakata kuzungumzia swala la gharama ya maisha kuwa juu, swala la kuongeza ushuru. Na sababu ya hao kukataa, nia yao ilikuwa ni kuongeza ushuru tena mwaka huu kupitia mswada wa fedha wa mwaka huu 2024. Na tuataka siku ya leo tuwaombe wabunge wetu, wale 88 waliopinga mwaka jana, tuwataka tena wapinge huu mswada wa mwaka huu, sababu ndio mbaya zaidi. Na unaongeza ushuru, kama kwa mafuta mwaka jana waliongeza 16% kutoka 8% VAT kwa mafuta. Na sasa tena tunasikia bado wanaongeza ushuru mwingine wa fuel levy kutoka 18% hadi 25%. Ushuru huu utaongeza gharama ya maisha, mawasiliano, kila kitu, mafuta yakienda juu, nauli, maisha ya kila mtu yatakuwa magumu zaidi. Ndio sababu tuomba wabunge wetu, haswa Waazimio waliosimama na Wakenya mwaka huu, tena wasimame nao. Na wenzetu walio kule Kenya Kwanza pia, wale 176, wajue ya kwamba Rais mstaafu Moi alikuwa nasema siasa mbaya, maisha mbaya. Lakini sera mbaya, maisha mbaya. sera mbaya kama hii ya fedha itaumiza watu katika maeneo bunge yenu, haijalishi kama ni wanaazimio ama wana Kenya kwanza. Na tuwaomba kwa muda huu uliosalia mswada ukija wiki ijayo, wabunge wetu wasisafiri, wabunge wetu wasikose kuwa bungeni, na wananchi muendelee kuweka hiyo pressure. Ile tulikuwa tunasema mulika mwizi, sasa mulika mbunge yako kabisa. Tujue wale watawasaliti 2027 chuma chao kimotoni. Kama muna maswala tuweza tukachukua machache.